Hi guys, this is Haunted School on the Star Destronics UK, and in today's video I'm going to be doing pretty much a how to repair video on singing fish, just so I aren't going over in pretty much every video on what I've done and how to fix everything. I thought I'd give you guys a bit of an instructional repair on how to get these things fixed. Specifically, the issue what's wrong with this one is the head mechanism. The gear is split and you know, it won't move if it's making a ticking sound or it's just completely jamming up when you try to move it. On this one, mouth is fine, and this is what it should sound like if there's no split gear. But yeah, I'm going to give you a demo of how this works currently and then we'll get into the repair. Head does not work, but we're gonna fix that. It's actually a new singing fish in my collection, by the way. This is the rocking singing bass version of Big Mouth Rainbow Trout, which I've wanted for a long time. So first off, we're gonna unplug it because we don't want it activating whilst we try and fix it. But yeah, it's the back. So what we'll need, of course, your gears, 9-tooth gears that this one takes for its head. I know some take a 10-tooth gear, such as Trevor Rainbow Trout, and you'll also need a screwdriver. But yeah, it has six screws on the back, and once these are all removed, you'll be able to access the fish. It does have batteries in as well, that's a good thing to note. But yeah, if we unscrew all of these screws, it's not doing this looking like through the camera. You can see this one's probably been mounted up on the wall before because it's got scratches on the back of the plaque. It normally happens because I do mount all my fish as well. Okay, and there's one more to go. Okay, so put that off. Try and remove it, and it's usually good to extend out the kickstand at the back. I'm going to do this off camera just in case I pull something. In fact, yeah, looks like there's one screw that's still holding it in, so I'll get that out and pull it apart for you guys. Okay, the fish pulled apart. As you can see, this is pretty much all it looks like inside. This is one of the knockoff fish, so a regular big mouth billy bass will look a slight bit different to this, but same thing. Pretty much, the board's in a different spot, so I'm gonna have to be careful with this. And also, if the wires are this short, in fact, I'm probably gonna unscrew that board whilst I'm repairing this or something, just so these wires up here don't pull off. And it's also a good idea to lean it up against the wall as well. But yeah, there you go. So, with it just being a head mechanism, we might be able to just try and sneak the camera in there. But you see there's two screws at the bottom which I'm pointing at. So I'm gonna focus. There's them two screws and there's also the two screws at the side, which both all of these will need coming out. And yeah, we'll get to the next part after this. We'll give me better access to these wires. So what we'll do now is unscrew both of these. Sometimes if the plastic is brittle, be very careful when doing this because you don't want to break these screw holders on either side of here, because this is what mounts the fish up pretty much. The screw is being a pain there. There we go. Put that up later. And we got these two at the bottom. But if you are planning on going inside the fish, you'll want to remove this bracket entirely, but I think we'll see how we go. But we should be able to do it by just doing these ones that hold the head mechanism in place. There's that one there. Seems like all the plastic is good. Don't quote me on that, but Here we go. So what we'll need to do, that's all loose now, is dislodge this motor a slight bit to the point where we can see them screws. But what I'm going to do, I'm going to unscrew that one. There should be a screw right at the other side as well. So I'm going to do this that bit off camera because it looks like it's going to be a bit fiddly. And then I'll show you guys once the motor is out. Okay, so picking up from last part, you got these two screws here. Keep these two screws aside and make sure to not mix them up with any of the ones that came from the plaque, because I think these are slightly bigger. But now what we've done, the top connector from here has been removed. It takes two screws to unplug it, and the motor has been dislodged. So what we're going to do now, we're going to test if this gear actually is split, and that should not be moving like that, that's for sure. In fact, get it to focus on the camera right here. That gear is split right down there, as you can see. But that's the thing that causes the head not to work. So what we're going to do, I'm going to pull out a new gear from this bag and put that on the motor and show you the difference. So on camera, I'm going to put this new gear on, and the requirement for this fish is a 90th gear, as I've said already, because already, yeah, this one's really tight. In fact, I'm going to do this off camera because I'll need to probably push it on with a screwdriver or something. Okay, so that went on with a bit of a fight. But what we're going to do now, we're going to put it back together. One quick tip is these wires look very thin, so be cautious that these are there, and you really won't want to pull them off, so be very careful. But yeah, this motor should sit right in there, and we'll turn all the way, and we're going to put the bracket in and start putting this thing back together. It looks like our motor is back bolted in, and just before we put this thing back together, give them a test to see if the head actually is not jammed, which that's the sound we should be looking for. That's going to work nicely. So what we're going to do now, we're going to put these four screws back in, and then yeah, put the base back together. If the fabric somehow comes dislodged from the screw holders, you will need to thread it back through the holes that is indicated in the fabric all around. Sometimes might be the best idea to take the entire bracket off just to do it properly and ensure that you don't pull any wires off in the process. But yeah, I think we're good to go. We're going to put this plaque back together. This fix should apply for any free motor singing fish, pretty much. Okay, it's back fully assembled, and it's very easy reassembling him. It's just the same as taking him apart, which is just doing it backwards. I found a reason why his batteries weren't working. They're all corroded, so I took them out. And yeah, let's give you a full demo of Big Mouth Rainbow Trout. Works amazing. The thing about this one as well, this one uses the head movement quite a lot, so it's quite crucial to have it working, really. But yeah, show you the other song.
Do you have a
love how the mouth and tail quiver on this one. It's something that's really good when it's incorporated into singing fish. But anyway, I hope you enjoyed this tutorial on how to repair pretty much the split gear for the head mechanism on a singing fish. You basically do the same thing for the tail and the mouth. If the gear is split, you just do the same thing. Yeah, you have to tape the skin off. You can do it without ripping it, so don't rip it. Just take your time and you should get there. The joints for the mouth and tail can also break, but that's a complete different story for another time that I'll do on this that I'll go over on this channel. But yeah, thank you for watching, and I'll see you all in the next video.